Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to ask the Minister and the Chair a question, and that is that what is the government's best estimate of the additional cost of borrowing to the government that flows from the lack of credibility of the current Minister of Finance? I want to know what is the premium on our debt repayments from having a Minister of Finance who has no credibility in New Zealand financial markets or internationally. Where in these estimates, I've been looking for it, for the $500,000 to be repaid by the Minister of Finance, the money that he has received or his family or his trusts have received as a result of declaring that he lives in Dipton. Is this money sitting in these accounts or not? Is it a credit against these expenditures? And more importantly, what is the cost to New Zealand of having a Minister of Finance with the lack of credibility that the current Minister has had? Because frankly, I cannot remember a time, and I go back, you know, I've been in this house with Sir Robert Muldoon, not while he was Minister of Finance and Prime Minister, but in the period immediately afterwards. And I cannot remember a time in all of those years where there was a Minister of Finance who was regarded as suspect by the financial community. Someone who didn't seem quite kosher and who you couldn't believe all the time. And frankly, who can believe the financial community when they know that they have a Minister of Finance who has declared that he lives in Dipton, when in fact everyone knows that he lives in Messines Road and has benefited hugely, about $500,000 over the decade that has occurred, at least $500,000 over that decade. Mr. Speaker, if we were in some other country, there'd be investigations, there'd be commissions. The person would not be in the job. We wouldn't have, well, unless we were in a corrupt country. If you were in a corrupt country, then the Prime Minister would accept that sort of behaviour. But generally in New Zealand, we've had much, much higher standards than that. In fact, when Transparency International and the OECD, when they've looked at us and our methods of ensuring proper behaviour on the part of ministers, they've had us right up there, and we've been proud of that. It's been, you know, you work your way back. You know, I disagreed greatly at different ends of the spectrum with Sir Robert Muldoon and Ruth Richardson. But one thing you would never accuse either of them of being was making false declarations in order to personally benefit. I think there's a possibility, if you go back to Keith Holyoake's time, I think that some of the actions of that government were slightly questionable, especially around the Western Access Road around Taupo and the personal benefit the then Prime Minister got from the opening up of Kinloch. But I think it's fair to say that since that time, certainly in the last 50 years, or pretty close to 50 years of New Zealand politics, there has never been a question of our interest rates being at a premium as a result of questions around the credibility and the personal reputation of the Minister of Finance in the way that we have it in here today. And sir, I think it is particularly interesting that there is not a single member of the House opposite who is prepared to defend Bill English in this matter. No one is, I mean, there are clear reflections on his character happening here, and not a person opposite.
Point of order, the Honourable Gerry Brownlee.
Mr. Speaker, I just want to make it clear that there is no response from this side because we simply consider Mr. Mallard to be a complete nullity in this.
No, that's not a point of order. The Honourable Trevor Mallard.
Mr. Speaker, in the half minute that I have left to me, I want to challenge members opposite to stand up in the next speech and say that they are comfortable with the approach that has been taken by the Minister of Finance with regard to the non-repayment of $500,000 he has received. I want them to stand up and tell this House that they think that's the sort of behaviour they want from their Minister of Finance.
I call Amy Adams.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. It is a great pleasure actually to take a call.